हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू लेक्चर नंबर 3 सब्जेक्ट क्वालिटी इंजीनियरिंग, यूनिट नंबर 2 क्वालिटी इंजीनियरिंग एंड मैनेजमेंट टूल्स टेक्निक्स एंड स्टैंडर्ड। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल सी रिगार्डिंग दी 7 न्यू क्वालिटी टूल्स पार्ट 1। प्रीवियसली वी हैव सीन दी 7 क्वालिटी कंट्रोल टूल्स। नाउ हियर देयर वी विल सी द 7 न्यू क्वालिटी टूल्स विच आर यूज टू इम्प्रूव द क्वालिटी of a product. Now the 7 new quality improvement tools, basically 7 quality control tools or you can say quality check tools are based on numerical data which we have seen in our previous video, and the problem is defined after collecting numerical data. So we have seen that in Fishbone chart or control chart or all other charts, we have seen histogram chart, or we have seen that we need to collect some numerical data, and thereafter the problem is defined, and we are reaching to the particular problem. It indicates analytical approach. Basic 7 quality tools are effective for data analysis, process control and quality improvement. So those 7 quality tools check are effective for the data analysis. Suppose we are analyzing any data, whether what is the product outcome or the what is the production rate compared to the sales, or what is the sales comparative to the production, how many types of means what is the rate of defect, or what is the rate of quality product. So it is all dependent on the data analysis. Then process control, how you are controlling the process, it is defined in the 7 quality control tools, and the quality improvement. New quality improvement tools are based on the verbal data, and it defines the problem before collecting numerical data. It means whatever the problem is being occurred, that problem is being defined before collecting the numerical data. It helps to generate ideas and formulate plan. So 7 new quality improvement tools are more helpful and more important than the 7 QC tools, as they give the verbal information based on the analysis, and we can generate idea and formulate the plan to avoid the whatever the problems are occurring during the process. They are basically developed to organize verbal data diagrammatically. So this is the difference between 7 quality control tools and the 7 new quality improvement tools. What is the benefit of incorporating new 7 quality tools? Why we need to go for this new 7 quality tools? What benefits we are getting as compared to that of 7 quality tools? In previous 7 quality control tools, we were able to find out the percentage of sale, or percentage of defect, or percentage of product. Now why, what is the additional benefit, or why this new 7 quality tools differs from that? So the first one is organize verbal data. Now in that, in previous we have seen that we are collecting some numerical data, and based on that numerical data we are coming to the conclusion that this is the problem, or this is the value, or this is the percentage of defect, or percentage of sales, or percentage of product we are finding it out. But in new 7 quality tools, quality check control tool, it organizes verbal data. There is no numerical data. It generates idea. Once based on this verbal data, you are able to identify the problem, and that will generate an idea to plan the production accordingly. It helps to improve planning. Once we know that what are the types of problems to be going to occur in future, based on that we can generate new ideas, and based on this new idea we can improve the planning of our production so that a company can run with a profit and with a good efficiency. Eliminates error and omissions. In old, that is 7 quality tools, we have seen that it will not eliminate the problem, it will identify the problem. While in the 7 new quality check tools, it will eliminate the error and omissions. So this is the major difference found between the old quality check tools and new quality check tools. In new 7 quality check tool, it eliminates the error. So once we are able to eliminate the error, then lot of money can be saved, lot of you can say material waste can be saved, and we can increase the production output, lot of time can be saved if we eliminate the error previously by identifying it. Then explains problem intelligibly. It means whatever the problem is being occurred, it is being explained very clearly, you can say intelligibly. So whatever the problem is being created, it is known to us well in advance, so that we can try to eliminate that error and increase the production rate. Secure full cooperation. These 7 quality check tools are, you can say, they are very cooperative, and it seeks secure full cooperation to the owner or to the industrialist. Persuade powerfully. Once it is executed, it will execute powerfully and give us the correct data of the analysis, whatever we are doing it. Assess situations from various angles. The main advantage of this critical or of this 7 quality check tools is it assesses the situation from various angles. That is an additional advantage of that, because in previous the old 7 quality check tools, the problem was identified based on the number which we are getting it. But here, depending on the assess situations from the various angle, we are able to identify the problem from all the different angles. So this is one of the additional and very clear advantage in the new 7 quality tools. Clarify the desired situation. Whatever the situation is arrived, it is very clearly known to us. So again, this will be a very beneficial to the person to identify the error and resolve it prior to the situation or prior to the production rate. So we can say this new 7 quality check tools are a kind of blessings to the quality management organization or department. Prioritize task effectively. What does it mean? It means that whatever the task we are planning it, it will perfectly inform the prioritized the whatever the task which we have, it will prioritize very effectively. So it becomes very easy to identify the problem and resolve it. Nowadays, in olden days, what were the problems? That after the production, we were able to find out the problems or defect, and later on we were going for the correction. But as the technology has been advanced, quality check tools has been developed, as they have improved, the percentage of defect, percentage of non-productive time has been reduced very drastically. Now,
The following, what are these 7 new quality tool checks? Remember, in previous lecture we have seen 7 quality check tools, and these are 7 new 7 quality check tools or quality control tools. So the first one is affinity diagram. Second is relation diagram. Affinity diagram shows the different types of affinities. Relation diagram, it shows the relation between the process. Tree diagram, how those systems develop and grows. Then in affinity diagram, you can say it collects the affinity statements or data of the system. Then in relation diagram, it realizes the relations between the primary cause, secondary cause and tertiary causes of the system. Then tree diagram, is used for systematically pursuing the best strategy for attaining an objective. It develops successions of strategies for achieving objective. It reveals method to achieve results. So to accomplish or to constrain primary, secondary, tertiary and quaternary. So step by step, the diagram indicates the step by step development growth of it. The next is matrix diagram. It helps for clarifying problems by thinking multidimensionally. So a matrix diagram shows the relationship between 2, 3 or 4 group of information which give information about the relationship, such as its strength, role played by various individuals or the measurements. So in matrix diagram we'll see regarding the different roles of the and roles and strength of the different you can say the different bodies or bar for individuals. Then the matrix data analysis. So matrix data analysis, it's very much similar to the matrix diagram, with a difference that numerical data is used instead of symbolic indicating the existence. In matrix diagram, the symbolic data or symbolic diagram is used, while in matrix data analysis the numerical data is used to produce numerical results. Then all these are having their different advantages in that. Then the next is arrow diagram. The arrow diagram shows the required order of task in the project or the process, the best schedule for the entire project and potential scheduling, the resource problem and their solutions. Friends, many times we have seen in the mass production that during the time of tapping we required to go for the drilling, but once the sequence is arranged that the product will reach after drilling to the tapping department, then we can save the time. So arrow diagram is very important for developing the path so that during manufacturing we can minimize the idling time. If the idling time is more than it can cause loss to the production department, and even there is loss in the financial aspects also. So arrow diagram indicates the critical path or the normal path, which shows how you can optimize the activity sequence of the activity, so that more than 2 activities, for example there are total 13 activities in that, so you can all the 13 activities are moving parallelly, then it will take much more time. But by analyzing the process, you can manage how process number 3, 4, 5 can work parallel, 6, 7, 8 can be executed parallelly, with 7, and then 9, 10, 11 can be the process working parallelly. So depending on the strategy or depending on the process time and type of activity, we can manage the process path for the production line. And the last one is process decision path, that is PDPC chart. PDPC program chart systematically identifies what might go wrong in the plan under development. Countermeasurements are developed to prevent or offset those problems. So by using PDPC, you can say process decision program chart, it can either revise the plan to avoid the problem or be ready with the best response when a problem occurs. So after executing the program, as I've shown you in the flow chart in my previous video, that when you are starting the process, after one or two process, if we find that there is rejection in the workpiece, or the workpiece is not with the, that precision or that quality, then it can again be sended back to the process number. For example, there are total 5 process for making a production of particular one item. Now process number 1, 2 is okay. Now when it is going for the process number 3, and if it is not according to the process number 3, then that product will again reverse and go to the product number 1, process number 1 or process number 2, whichever is required. So when after process number 4, when it is reaching to process number 5, if process number 5 is not adequate, it can again reverse to the process number 4, go for the correction and reach for the process number 5. After the process number 5 is okay, our goal is achieved, then particular product is considered to be okay. So friends, depending on this 7 new quality check tools, it identifies that this quality check tools are verbal quality check tools, and it helps a lot for planning and minimizing the saving the time, saving the material, saving the, you can say, unnecessary usage of the electricity. So I think all these 7 quality check tools are very important from the quality point of view. So friends, during the examination, you don't get confused between the 7 quality check tools and new 7 quality check tools. See, the previous 7 quality check tools also were the charts, and these are also somewhat the diagrammatic figure. So don't get confused between these two. It is clearly specifying that they, all the 7 quality check tools, old one are based on the numerical data and new one are based on the visualization and the logic of the production line. So don't get confused in that. So thank you very much for watching this video. I request you all to subscribe our channel, SSIT.Gandhinagar. Thank you.